Welcome back to Plecter Labs. Today we're going to have a tutorial on bench power supply. I consider that tool as absolutely essential in your workshop because any kind of electronics that you want to test first, give a try, or ensure that it's working properly, you need that tool for that. It's called PSU power supply unit, or also bench power supply. You can find those for about $60 to $80, depending on the model that you choose. You can find those on Amazon's and probably also at Sparkfun Electronics. Pretty much everywhere, actually. They are quite easy to source. They basically all look like the same. So this is a metal case with a heatsink at the back with the AC cord connection. So this one is compatible with 110 volts as well as 240. Make sure you choose one that has two indicators. So that indicator is an amp meter. It's going to indicate you the current that you're using at a certain moment. And the other one is the voltage that you regulate the power supply on. So aside of that, I have two wire clips here that are connected to the plus and minus output of the power supply, and we're going to see how it works in a minute. All right, so we have our power supply here. So the first thing, obviously, with that kind of power supply is that you can set the voltage. It's nothing really different compared to any kind of wall mount adapter. Usually some of those have a sliding switch that allows you to select to have a coarse adjustment of the voltage. Usually it's a set of 4 to maybe 8 different voltages. Some of them are regulated, some of them are not regulated. This power supply obviously is regulated, which means that whatever the current that is taken out from here, if it's below the limit, we're going to see the limitation of the current in a moment. If it stays below the limit, the voltage will remain stable regardless the amount of current that is taken out from the power supply. So this particular power supply has two knobs for setting the voltage. One is the coarse, as it's indicated here. The other one is the fine tuning. So the fine tuning has about 0.5 volts of range, which makes it very handy to have a very precise adjustment. This is a voltmeter, nothing else. So basically it represents the voltage that is output from the terminals here. We'll see later in another video, probably the one dedicated to measuring a high power LED, that the voltage that is here isn't the same voltage exactly that the one that you will have at the end of the wire clips. So for now, it's a good indicator of the voltage anyway, so you can use that to just basically decide what you want to set as your voltage. The other indicator is an amp meter, and it's going to show what kind of amount of current you're pulling out of the power supply. So for now, it's displaying zero because obviously there is nothing connected to my power supply. Those two knobs here, so they behave exactly the same as the ones on the right side, but for the current. The essential difference that you have to understand with a bench power supply is that you're not going to set the current in the sense that you're going to force the unit to send out something. It's going to be a current limitation that you set here. So the reading that you will have will display the current that is being used at a certain moment, but the knobs here are not going to force any kind of current. It's going to limit the amount of current that you can pull out, and this is precisely the essential use of a bench power supply, which goal is to protect the device that you power by avoiding that you have too much current sent to your device if something goes wrong, or if it's broken, or if you want to diagnose it, whatever. And we will see that it's very handy to have that feature, especially when we want to measure a high power LED forward voltage in the next video. So here, if you want to see how to set your maximum current, this is very simple to achieve actually. You're going to make a short circuit between your two terminals, like that. I know it sounds weird, but the device is designed for that, and there is absolutely no reason to be afraid to break something. And I'm going to slowly increase the voltage, and you will see that immediately I have the continuous voltage LED here that is going off, which means that we've reached some sort of limitation somewhere. And you have on the opposite, you have the current indicator that went on, which means that the limit has been triggered for the current. So right now, with a short circuit, obviously there is as much current as possible flowing in the circuit, and this knob is going to adjust it. So here I'm going to put the limit to, let's say, 700 milliamps, but you can see that the voltage totally dropped almost to zero. So even if there is a lot of current flowing in the circuit path, it's not going to damage anything because there is no voltage. So basically a voltage close to zero multiplied by a big current equals a power which is close to zero, so nothing is going to happen. So now that we have our limit, it can be interesting actually on that indicator to make a small mark with some tape, with a Sharpie or something like that, just to be sure that we can come back to that setup later without the need of doing the short circuit thing. Basically, we have 700 here, which is a useful value for instance, rebel LEDs. We can go back also to 1 amp and have the 1 amp mark here so that we know that we have that current limitation set when the main knob is here, and we can still have a fine adjustment of the current using the other knob. So now that you have set your maximum current that the system can accept, we will be able to power an LED, and the nice thing is that we don't have to focus too much on the voltage that we're going to apply to it, because there is no way it can go above the current limitation that we decided earlier. So I'm going to put it here on the flat surface. I don't have any heatsink on that one, so I'm not going to abuse the LED. It's a Knoll Luxon 3 red, and I'm going to increase the current. So as you can see, it starts to light up at, let's say, 2 volts, something like that. And then I'm going to hit the limit, and I'm at almost 1 amp, which is my limit that I set earlier. And as you can see, even if I increase the voltage, I turn the knob on the right side, nothing happens. It stays at 1 amp because my current limitation is set to that value. So basically the pinch power supply is automatically limiting the current and therefore the voltage that is applied to the LED, so that voltage doesn't go higher, and by definition the current can go higher neither. So the power remains constant. And if I want to turn it down just a little bit, I'm going to go back to, let's say, 600, so that doesn't heat too much, or even 500. I can set my current here, 500, and I have my LED running at 500 milliamps. So now, let's say that I'm going to turn the voltage knob to the maximum. When I'm going to release the circuit, you're going to see the voltage here jump to the maximum and goes back to 24 volts, which matches the maximum position of the knob here. And just to show you that it works and it's not dangerous, except that my wire just broke here, I'm going to do it manually. I'm going to apply directly 25 volts but the current is going to flow back immediately to 500 milliamps, and the voltage is going to be limited to the proper voltage so that it doesn't go above that. And the LED will totally survive, it's not going to be harmed at any level. So you go like that, and you hit the limit instantly within a few milliseconds, and your LED is not going to be harmed at all. Where is it? And there we go. I have to show that in the video. Plug it back, and you can see on the readings that we stay at 500 milliamps. So this is it. This is the main use of the bench power supply. Keep in mind that you definitely want to set a limit somewhere. Most of those modern, I would say, power supply have only indicators here. Not indicators, knobs that have no indication of the current you're going to set here. So it's not very easy to just visually know that the limit is at 1 amp or 2 amps. So you definitely have to use the short circuit method to be sure what the maximum current is. On other kind of power supplies, like the one that is here, which is my personal one I built a long time ago, probably 15 or 20 years ago, the current limitation is a little bit different and probably a little bit more accurate, or I would say modular in this case, because basically you have several ranges here. This is 100 milliamps, 500 milliamps, and 2 amps. So basically I can choose, depending on the kind of device that I want to power with this. This is also a multi-turn potentiometer to set the voltage in a more accurate way. So here, if I want to power a small microcontroller or Arduino board, and I want to be sure that I'm not going to damage anything if it's the first time I test the board, I'm going to select 100 milliamps. If I'm working on a crucial focus soundboard and I'm testing a prototype, I'm probably going to be here at 500 milliamps because I need a little bit of headroom for the audio amplifier and eventually accent LEDs. And if I want to test a complete soundboard with the high power LED and more, I'm going to move to the 2 amps settings, and basically the readings here is going to correspond to 2 amps. So the middle one is matching the scale that is here. Otherwise you have to be used to the device and read things here. This could be digital as well, it would make absolutely no difference. What is interesting here is that you can select basically manually the kind of range depending on the kind of application, instead of searching for the marking on the knob. So that's it for today. I hope you liked this video and it was useful to you. The bench power supply is quite inexpensive. I mean, it's about 60 to 70 US dollars. You can find them on Amazon, like I said, it's definitely something you want to have, especially if you're working a little bit with electronics in general, not just sabers. It's going to be so useful. So in the next video, I'm going to explain how to use the bench power supply to measure your high power LED for the use of a nano biscotte soundboard or other soundboard using die drive. Okay, see you later.